Abraham was not weak in faith. It gives us a clue about faith. He didn't consider his own body. Now, weak faith always considers the circumstances. Strong faith considers the word. Strong faith considers what God says. Strong faith takes the word over the circumstances. He didn't consider his own body because he wasn't weak in faith. He considered the word of God over his circumstances. Being not weak in faith, he did not consider his own body already dead since he was about 100 years old in the deadness of Sarah's womb, and not being weak in faith, and he did not waver at the promise of God. He didn't stagger. That reminds me of James. Let him ask in faith with no wavering. For he that wavers is like a wave of the sea driven and tossed by the wind. He said, let not that man that wavers, don't even let him think he's going to get anything from God. Don't think you're going to get anything. Don't even let him go there and think you're going to get anything from God when you're wavering. Abraham didn't waver in his faith. Do you waver when it comes to what God said? If you're in a situation right now and you don't know how you're going to pay the bills, you don't know how you're going to get well when the doctor gave you a negative report, you don't know how your children are going to be delivered or restored or get back in fellowship with God. But don't waver at God's promise. If you cast your children on the Lord, he has it, and trust him. Don't waver. The Bible says when you cast the whole of your care, all your anxiety, all your concern, once and for all on him, for he cares for you affectionately, and he cares about you watchfully. If you believe in God for healing, be fully persuaded in what God says. What word are you standing on? Are you standing on Matthew 8:17, for example? Himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. Be fully convinced that by his stripes you were healed. It's just a matter of time. See, be followers. Don't be weary. Be followers of those through faith and patience inherit the promises. That's how you inherit the promises, through faith and patience. Those are the power twins right there. You need them both, because after you believe, you receive. You don't have the manifestations yet. That's why you believe it. So you need patience between the time you believe, you receive, and whoop, there it is. You need a patience that after you've done the will of God, after you believe, you receive the promise. Abraham didn't waver God's promises, but through unbelief. That's what unbelief is, just wavers at God's promises. No, he was strong in faith, giving glory to God. There's another key. Strong faith is being fully convinced, verse 21, and being fully convinced that what God had promised, he was able to perform. So here's some keys, some very important keys about faith here. He was strong in faith, giving glory to God. See, when you give glory to God when you are sick and you're giving glory to God for your healing, you're strong in faith.